Welcome back to Probe the Act on Deepstuff Radio. Thanks for joining us. Enjoy the show. Welcome back to Probe the Act on Deepstuff Radio with Emmy Hikins and a lovely singer-songwriter, Farnz Cordeaux, all the way from Tasmania in Australia, and off the band Silver Beets in Australia. He's a singer-songwriter and a musician. Can you tell us about your social media presence, which is Facebook, Twitter, and all that? Go for it.
Yep, certainly can. So, of course, we've pretty much got everything. The only thing I heard you mention before was Instagram.
Yeah.
I don't actually have that as yet.
Okay.
But we've got our own website where we do post up all our pics. We recently did our debut launch, and I've got a whole heap of pics that have been sent to me that I've got to post up yet.
Yeah.
But that's how I found you guys, was through Twitter.
Yeah.
Twitter's been fantastic. I think I spent, so the album came out at the very end of January, the EP.
Yeah.
And I think I was on Twitter from about August last year, just trying to find radio stations and magazines and bloggers and all about music, that and just hook up with these people in the knowledge that at some point I was going to have a product.
Yeah.
And it just keeps on snowballing. And it's one of those things, you talk about the hard work, it's not just about the music. I have spent hours on, like, every night. Like, when we had our debut launch on the 21st of February.
Yeah.
And I think in that 3 weeks beforehand, because I was on holidays before that, I had to go up and visit family up in Sydney.
Yeah.
And so I came back, we had 3 weeks where we had to rehearse, pretty much every single night.
Yeah.
And I would get out of the studio at 11 o'clock at night, and I would spend nearly 2 to 3 hours on social media, sending the material out to radio stations, to labels, to just anyone, and just even if it's just that they have a listen and it gets your name out there, there's nothing may come of it right now, but maybe in the next album or something, they're right, these guys are serious, they're putting out music, it's good music, it's well played, it's professional, let's give these guys a shot, mate. It does take a lot of work. And Facebook's the same. We've got a Facebook page. If you typed in The Silver Beets into Facebook, you'd find us. We've got our own website, www.thesilverbeats.com.
Wow.
And it is Silver Beets with a double E, so it is like the plant. You in the UK call it anything differently? Is it Silver Beet?
Silver Beets is. Well, I've noticed that you're
like a spinach.
It's spelled with B, with a double E, like you said.
Yeah. And so I know that there's other names. I think people call it Swiss chard and so forth like that. But essentially, for us here in Australia, we know it as Silver Beet.
All right.
I can't tell you exactly why I chose that name. I think I'd sat down, I had like 2-3 pages of different names different times.
Yeah.
And where you just kind of like, nah, not that one, not that one, not that one. And in the end, we just kind of settled on that. And a friend did the logo for me. And I was like, you know what? That works.
Yeah.
And then you just kind of like, once you've got the brand, you just kind of run with it, right?
Yeah.
And, so we've got a logo. We've got the logo of the word. We've got a little leaf logo that looks like a silver bee.
Yeah.
And then it's just, tacking that brand to us of a certain quality and standard.
Yeah. Wow. That's brilliant. Yeah. One thing that I forgot to mention was about your YouTube. Do you have any?
Yes.
Yes.
My bass player he's getting into web design, and he's been learning all about PHP and SQL and so forth. And he was like, we've got to have a YouTube.
Yeah.
I don't care whether or not we've got any footage.
Yeah.
And we do have some footage coming up for a film clip. We've got some friends that have got cameras that have taken some stuff.
Yeah.
But essentially, he's grabbed the songs and he's grabbed the album artwork, and he's got them up on YouTube.
Brilliant. So Do you know the page, or is it on your website?
It should be just the Silver Beats.
Yeah.
Under the YouTube.
Yeah.
But if not, it will be on the website.
Brilliant, brilliant. Yeah, so our listeners can always go to www.thesilverbeats, and it's spelled with double E.com. That's brilliant.
Yep, that's covered. It.
Yeah. Right, so here's a really difficult question. What would you do if there was no music?
I contemplate that. Yeah, because it's there from the time we're born. You know, it's one of those primal things. One of the guys I grew up with in the first band was from Mauritius, and he said his first memory is sitting there on the beach in Mauritius playing a little bongo in between his legs.
Yeah.
You know, music's just there for all of us. I mean, apart from those who are deaf, you know, and they probably have something else. I don't know, but it's just art, and human Homo sapiens just love art and love music, and that's what we get remembered by.
Yeah.
And that's why cave paintings from, you know, 40,000 years ago still grab our attention.
Wow. So you can't imagine a world without music then?
I can't. I seriously can't. You know, I remember kids, when we were sort of first starting out at 18, what would you really like? You know, would you lose your eyesight? Would you lose your hearing? And, you know, those who didn't play music would be like, oh, I'd go without my hearing. Just, you know, I want to see everything. And those who really loved music would be like, no, I care about not, you know, being able to see as long as I can hear.
That's a brilliant analogy, yeah. So we're going to take a short break now. Please don't go away. You're listening to Probe the Act on Deepstuff Radio with Emmy Hikins and a lovely singer, songwriter, and the front man of the band, these Silver Beats, all the way from Tasmania in Australia. We'll be back shortly. Please don't go away.